Hey, I'm the Voiceover Beard, here with Shure to show you how to record your voice in top quality for your podcast, voiceovers, films, and music projects. How do you do that? Let's talk about it. The focus of this segment is on proper mic placement. We've got three staples from Shure's lineup of pro microphones, and they're each quite different. The SM27 large diaphragm condenser mic, the VP82 shotgun condenser mic, and the SM7B dynamic mic. Let's go. For this demo, we're in my actual closet rather than my sound-treated studio, just to prove that you don't necessarily need any fancy room treatment, just a quiet place with soft materials and away from any windows. Closets are perfect for all sorts of quiet and private activities. All of these mics have an analog XLR output, which means we'll need an analog-to-digital interface like this, the extra-portable and laughably indestructible MVI. Love this little dude. Let's set up the SM27 large diaphragm condenser mic. XLR out, XLR in, USB out, and USB in. Easy. Crank on your phantom power. Check your gain level and make sure you're loud but still in the green so you don't peak or distort your sound. Now, large diaphragm condenser mics are extremely sensitive. They have a pickup pattern that's attuned to sounds coming from directly in front of them as well as from the sides, top, and bottom. So if you have a noise source like a vent or a window, try to keep those behind the mic. And remember, the front of the mic is here, not here. I see this all the time. Oh God. The way you address your mic makes a big difference. Addressing it from too far away and setting your gain level higher will introduce more room noise and reverberation. Addressing it closely and compensating with a lower gain level will eliminate those artifacts, but too closely and you could wind up with extra bass due to the proximity effect. Keep a fist between you, or maybe you want to hang loose. Another important point is addressing the mic off axis. That means not speaking directly at the diaphragm, but rather grazing the edge. The mic should be candidly eavesdropping on your speech. Don't worry, it can hear you. Think of the diaphragm as someone's ear. You don't have to drive it home. Just get there. This smooths out the dynamics of your voice, so loud vowels and hard consonants don't spike your waveform. Some folks like to move it off to the side, and others raise it high and point it down towards the chest, which actually adds some resonance. Alright, let's try using the same principles to properly place the VP82 shotgun condenser mic. Now, I love shotgun mics because they actually reject room noise much better due to the supercardioid pickup pattern. They're most sensitive from the front and least sensitive from the sides, so set yourself up 90 degrees to the noise. They also pick up sound clearly from much further away, so you have a lot more flexibility with distance from the microphone. But you have to remain very still when delivering speech because this thing is a sniper rifle. You can't just spray and pray. So, those are our condenser mics. Let's move over to the SM7B dynamic mic and see the difference. This is the SM7B. You've seen it, you know it, you love it. This guy is notorious for requiring a lot of gain from your interface, so if your built-in preamp is too weak, you'll need a signal booster like this FET head by Triton. That's the only difference in setup, but how does this thing behave sonically? This mic is designed to be addressed from very, very close range. The recessed diaphragm is an indication that it's ready for you to get romantically up close and personal with it. It wants to know your secrets. If you tell it the right things, it will reject all other suitors and remain faithful to you. So when addressing this mic, give it what it wants. Be there for it. Express your tender love and devotion. But of course, you can be a little coy about it. Speak off-axis and tease it a little bit. It likes that.
So, those are just three varieties of microphones included in Shure's lineup. Whether you're doing field recordings outside, narrating an audiobook, or podcasting with a group, Shure has you covered since literally before you were born. Again, I am the Voiceover Beard. Follow me on Instagram for some more vaguely relevant content.